Interviews. How to get better sound in your interviews. Where do you stick the mics? How do you avoid getting lots of noise? This week, we're talking interviews. There are various types of interview situation that you might find yourself in. And we're going to look through those now. And I have a very lovely assistant. You have to do a 1980s game show pose like that. With a handheld mic, you might find yourself using this a lot if you were doing some sort of vox pops or out on the street doing various bits and pieces with the public or in like a trade show. It's a really handy mic to have. And as we've said before, it's very directional.
If you listen to my voice now, hello, welcome to the 1980s game show. And if I move it away from my mouth, you obviously can hear the difference. So if I was doing an interview with Jody in a trade show, or where would we be? Where would we be?
Red carpet.
So let's assume we're on the red carpet of the...
Met Gala.
The Met Gala. Right, so at the Met Gala. So the Met Gala red carpet. And so we're going to do a little fake interview. So it's, hello, and with me on the red carpet at the Met Gala, I have Jody. Hi, Jody.
Hi, Rick. How are you?
I'm really well, thank you.
And with 24 billion followers on TikTok, obviously, you know, you're hoping to show your followers tonight your outfit, of course.
I know. Very inspirational, don't you think?
Yes, let's make a TikTok about it. So if I ask Jodie a question, but I don't give her the microphone, you'll hear the difference in sound. So say, hey, Jodie, welcome to the red carpet. Tell us about your outfit tonight.
Hi, Rick. I'm glad you noticed my nice outfit tonight.
So you can hear that she's off mic, and the reason you use this mic is exactly that, so you can reject all the off-axis sound.
Ditched the handheld microphone, and Jodie and I are on, well, I've been on a lav the whole time. So over here, you can hear it whistling. I've got my lav mic, and Jodie's also got one secreted about her person just over there. So this is also another way of recording an interview. Now, this is much more suitable if you're in an environment that's a little quieter. So where we are now is perfect. There's two of us on a lav mic. Now, the trade-off is if I'm doing an interview with Jodie, or I'm a guest and I'm being filmed and Jodie's also on a lav mic, her mic will pick up my voice. So I'll stay quiet and I'll ask her a question and I'll fade up my microphone and turn hers down. So Jodie, how are you doing today? Tell me about where were you this week?
This week, Rick, I was in Oslo, actually, for a team meeting. Only got back last night, so pretty tired, but here I am.
Lots of mixers, like the Zoom F6 that I'm using, have what's called an auto mix feature. So when the recorder senses that there's no input on Jodie's mic channel, it will drop Jodie's mic channel. The same sort of thing as turning the dial, if you like, or dropping the gain to zero. And when she starts talking, it kind of senses that and it will bring it back up. So it does that balancing for you. And it's actually pretty good. It's not as good as doing it yourself. Now, in edit, what I would do is I would manually do this. So I would drop the channel of Jodie's mic, let me speak, and then I would fade her back up when you speak. It's a bit more time intensive, but it's the best way to do the mix. Another option, of course, for recording interviews is to bring in our old friend, the shotgun mic.
Hello. Now, this is very directional, as we've discussed in the other episodes. We're indoors. We're going to keep a windshield on it because it will help us get rid of the plosives. When you do the P's and the B's, it won't be such an intense sound and the mic won't go all a bit funny. So if I show the difference, I've done this before. It doesn't really affect it acoustically, but if I'm going Peter Piper picked a peck of pickled pepper, and we put it back, Peter Piper picked a peck of pickled pepper. See, it's slightly different and you're not getting that harshness. Now, we could use it like a handheld mic on the pistol grip. So we could go, hi, Jodie, how are you?
Hi, Rick, I'm good, thank you. How are you?
Welcome to the Met Gala red carpet. Strength of using this is that you're going to get a lot more rejection from the back noise and also from the sides. However, it's quite unsightly, and handheld mics are designed to be handheld and they're designed to kind of look okay on camera.
And all these different mics that we've looked at, they will work equally well seated or standing in an interview. I mean, we've been standing up here because it's actually quite nice. You can move your arms around and you can look awkward and nod at me.
Yeah.
Yep, awkward nodding. It's that, the out and dead. Actually, interestingly, when you watch TV presenters, this is an aside, but they don't know what to do when the other person's talking, so they just sort of do what you're doing, it very well. They sort of nod, and you nod, and you're thinking, they're not listening, are they? The Ant and Dec do it all the time. They go, It's quite annoying. Or like, we could be like Phil and Holly.
Oh, we could.
We could like jump cues and stuff. Big thanks to Jodie for allowing me to push various microphones in front of her face and ask her some weird questions about stuff that we made up on the spot. But thank you.
Thanks for having me. It's been a pleasure, Rick.